welcoming you all in today's lecture of Accountancy Standard 12, Chapter Number 3, Valuation of Goodwill. So, there are basically two types of assets. One is my non-current assets and the other is my current assets. In non-current assets, there is FOMO classification, fixed assets. Okay, in that part, there are two more classifications, one is tangible and one is intangible assets. So basically goodwill is a intangible asset. As you can see, goodwill, it depends upon the profit of the business. The firm which is earning maximum profit as compared to other firm running the same type of business which will have the goodwill. It depends upon the reputation of the business. It is an intangible asset. We can not touch it. Okay, we just can value it out, the goodwill of the business. Okay, so now I will explain you the meaning. Goodwill is an intangible asset which shows the reputation of the firm in the market. Goodwill is an intangible asset which shows the reputation of the firm in the market. Now I would like to explain you the factors which are affecting the business. So basic first factor is nature of business. So what is the nature of business? Is my business having a high value product? Means my product is very much famous in the market. Okay. And if I am having a stable sales, in that particular case is I am having good. Second is my location of the business. Is if my business is located centrally in the city, okay, if this is center case, city of the center, if my business is that, in that particular cases, I might be having much more amount of goodwill. Period of goodness. If I am running the business since last 5 years, 6 years, 10 years, I am very old to the business, I am having that so many customers, then in that particular cases, period of goodness affects the business, it is positivity for the business. A new entrepreneur will take much more time to establish himself into the market, but an old entrepreneur can easily get the amount of goodwill because many customers I am in contact with in your market situation. If I am running a business on monopoly, okay, I am the single seller in the market, then in that particular cases I might be having much amount of goodwill. Efficiency of the employees, okay. Employees you can see, even you can see the managers. If my manager is efficient, if my employees are efficient, working dedicatedly towards the enterprise, okay, then that case might be possible. Okay, my product is very much famous, my product is the best product in the market. Okay, so based on that efficiency of the employees and the management, okay, my reputation in the market can increase and it will ultimately increase the amount of goodwill. Other special benefits, okay. Other special benefit means my business having license, trademark, patent. So these all things also help in the valuation of the goodwill. These all things also help for the reputation of the firm. Okay. I'll explain to you why we need the necessary for valuation of goodwill. Why do we value the amount of goodwill? So number one is change in profit and loss ratio. Even a partnership firm, okay, if the partners are distributing the profit beforehand equally. Now they want to distribute the amount in the ratio of suppose 5, 3 and 2, 3 partners were there. First the ratio were equal, 1, 1, 1. Now they have decided for 5, 3 and 2. In that particular cases, once again we need to value the amount of goodwill. While admitting a partner, we need to value the amount of goodwill. While retirement of a partner, we need to value the amount of goodwill. Death of a partner needs for valuation of goodwill. Conversion of partnership firm into company. If you are running a partnership firm which has a maximum capacity of 100 partners, now if I want to establish or increase my business, expansion, modernization in that particular case, I need more partners. Okay. So, regular citizen partnership at 1932, that maximum only 100 must be there. But I want more, I want to expand myself, I want more money. So, I want to convert myself into a company. In that case also, I have to value the amount of goodwill. And that amalgamation of firm. Two firms, when they amalgamate, both the firms need to value the amount of goodwill. Maruti Suzuki. These are both different companies, but they are all together merging of the company. At that time, Maruti and Suzuki, both the company need to evaluate the amount of goodwill. Methods. Now, the methods with the help of which we can find the amount of goodwill is such, number one, average profit method. Okay, average profit method. This is the method in which years are given, profit is given, profits and loss might be given. You just have to find the total, just had to add the profit, and if loss is given, deduct the loss. Okay, then whatever amount you are getting, you will get the total profit. Then first of all, you have to find the average profit. Total profit upon total number of years, you will get the average profit. Then goodwill, average profit multiplied by number of years purchased. It is already given in the sum itself. When we will solve the sum, we will come to know. So first, in this matter, first we got to find average profit. Total profit upon total number of years, then we got to find goodwill. Okay, average profit multiplied by number of years purchased. Second is my weighted average profit method. So weighted average profit. This profit method, this goodwill method will only be applicable if the profit of the firms year by year increases or decreases. It should be in a continuous real order. It will be increased. Suppose 1 lakh, then 140, then 190, then 3 lakh, then 5 lakh. Okay, so it will be increased. Randomly it will increase, but it will increase. It will be increasing trend. Then we can apply this particular method. Okay, in that we got to allocate the weight 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We got to allocate the weights. We got to multiply profit with weight, we will get weighted profit. Adding that weighted profit, we will get total weighted profit. Then first of all, we got to find in this weighted average profit. So what is weighted average profit? What is the formula for it? Total weighted profit, which we have got by multiplying profit with weight, adding it up, we got total weighted profit upon total number of, upon total weight. Total weight we have allocated, adding it up, we get total weight. Okay. As we got the answer for weighted average profit, then we got to find goodwill. The goodwill equal to weighted average profit, whatever the answer has come, multiply by number of years purchased, it is already given in the sum. Next is my super profit method. In this case also, first of all, we got to find the average profit. Okay. Then, we got to find after average profit. Okay. Then we got to find the expected profit. Capital employed multiplied by expected weight of return. Okay. It is already given in the sum. To find the capital employed, okay, total assets and total outside liabilities might be given in the sum. Okay, so from total assets, you got to deduct total outside liabilities, you got capital employed, multiply the expected rate of return. Okay, we will get it from here. Then you got to find super profit. So average profit minus expected profit, you will get the super profit. And then goodwill equal to super profit multiplied by number of years purchased. Last method, capitalization of profit method. In this particular method, first of all, you got to find the average profit. Then after finding the average profit, you got to find the capitalized profit. So, average profit divided by expected rate of return multiplied by 100, you will get the capitalized profit. Then capital employed, find the one in the sum itself. If it is given, then it's okay. And if it is not given, then you got to find total assets minus total outside liabilities. You will get the amount of capitalized profit. Then goodwill equal to capitalized profit minus capital employed, we get the amount of goodwill. By this way, we can find the amount of goodwill. This chapter, chapter number 3 and chapter number 4, merging it up, carries 9 marks in the board examination. 3 marks sums are going to be asked from this particular chapter. So you got to learn the theoretical part also, and you got to learn the formulas also. The small chapter is there, it carries total 3rd and 4th chapter carries 9 marks. Okay. So all the best and learn the chapter. I think I can.